Just as sprinkle stardust and you whisper, go to sleep, everything is alright. So this is a video for Patreon, and I'm going to be doing pencils. So I've got thumbnails here. The original look like this. This is an enlargement, actually, of them. It goes with the script, and I got notes. So this part of this, my notes for the project, for this page. Made some small changes, like turning these into bubbles. And now I'm penciling over the blown up thumbnails, which I've turned into light blues, and working out the details, and then using a fine brush pen to roughly ink out. So these are my actual, what I'm calling pencils. The clean version that's ready to then be blown up even larger, and I'm doing these on A3 sheets, so something approximately similar to 11x17. And then I'll add even more detail when I do that. But right now I'm getting like all the posing and some of the lighting stuff figured out, and costuming, rough patterns for hairs. It's fairly simple. It could be doing, this could be, for some people, a style they would, the way they would draw a comic, but for me that's my roughs. I like to refine the line a bit more. Yeah, so that's what I'm doing. So I'm going to go over these in here and try to bring it up to this level before doing that. Now I'm pulling out details. Don't worry about 21 years old. Don't worry about getting it too perfect or anything, but I want to map in a clean version of what I intend to do for the art. So now I'm taking an additional amount of care. Usually it makes a difference between really good work and really rushed work and kind of amateur work is that extra bit of time and care it's given. Even when you're doing commercial work and it's a bit rushed, taking a little bit of time to put a polish on things before sending them off to a client. It's always a good idea. You want to, as much as you can, stay reasonably physically loose, even when you're doing more careful stuff. The solution isn't to tighten up to be more precise, tense up. It's actually more relaxed, but more controlled. Thank you. often at this stage, I'm trying to refine things, but for example, likeness, I'm going to worry about more at the next stage. And in favor of precision with these, I like a little bit of looseness, a little bit of energy. Definitely don't want to be tracing the rough thumbnail too much. Tracing's always bad. Whether you're cleaning up your thumbnails or inking your pencils, you never want to actually be tracing. That'll always give you more derivative line. Trying to think about making her posing feel more dynamic with the forms.
talk about my basic drawing exercises, taking advantage of the natural arc of your arm. That's what I'm doing right now. Oops, I don't want to go in there though. That's a wall. There we go. Okay. So you get the idea. Rough thumbs these. I'll turn these into blues again. Blow them up bigger and again refine. This, at that stage, I usually switch to generally going a little slower and being more precise. Let's see, I should have something here. Should have thought of that in advance. Pencils actually made it smaller for the thumbnail, sorry. But the thumbnail is actually bigger. And then zoom up. This is what the final enlarged version. I blew them up on a yellowy paper I picked up in Toronto. And then again, I turn these blue, get rid of the yellow and the blue line, and turn the black pencil and graphite line light blue. And those get printed out. And that's another video. That's another look at my iterative roughing, refining, and finishing process used for comics, but also illustration work and pretty much all my drawing. Occasionally I'll do something improv with no plan, just from scratch, but that's actually pretty rare as a professional artist. It's a fun, it's a pleasure usually, getting just play with no real plan. But usually I have a script and things I have to follow and very specific goals and after, because I'm doing narrative art most of the time. And that imposes a lot of very particular parameters on what things can do and be. Oh, that's my stomach. Time to go eat. All right.